In this video, we're looking at the beta decay of cesium-137, and we're told there's two different pathways for this to occur. So first, you could have a beta decay directly to barium-137. Notice in the periodic table here, we're bouncing one space to the right in the periodic table, because a beta decay means that a neutron has turned into a proton in the nucleus, and then a high-energy electron is emitted. That's called a beta particle. We're then told there's a second pathway for cesium-137 to decay into barium-137. And what happens here is a lower energy beta decay, and we're told it's 0.51 MeV for the electron, that leaves the nucleus in an excited state. And that means we're looking at barium-137 star, that's called metastable barium-137. And this is just a higher energy state in the nucleus. When that nucleus decays back down to its ground state energy, the extra energy is going to be carried off by a photon because we don't have any particle transformations happening in that decay. So this is exactly the kind of process that creates gamma radiation. Now we're given a list of reference values here. We have the atomic mass unit in MeV per C squared, and we have the mass of a cesium-137 atom given in atomic mass units, and the mass of a barium-137 atom given in atomic mass units. Now it's just unfortunately the case that the tables you look these things up in, first of all, they typically don't give these masses in MeV per C squared, which would be nice for doing nuclear physics. They're given in atomic mass units. So we have to do that conversion. And then a second source of confusion is that these are the masses of the atoms, including their electrons. So if I'm looking at a beta decay of cesium-137, I'll just leave the neutrons out of the notation for now because I don't need them. I have an electron emitted, or a beta particle emitted. Has a charge of -1 and a mass number of 0. And just for completeness, there's an electron antineutrino emitted and its mass is negligible. So a common source of confusion, if I'm comparing the mass of what went into this reaction to the mass of what comes out, it can be tempting to include the mass of that beta particle or electron. But because of the way our tables are constructed, we've already counted the electron. Barium has one more proton in the nucleus, so it's surrounded by 56 electrons. That's already been accounted for in the way this table was constructed for the mass of the barium-137 atom, including all of its electrons. So don't double count that electron. It's already been included in the mass you're about to write down for the mass of the barium atom. And again, I don't care about the neutrino because it's approximately massless. So then I'm asked to get the maximum energy for the electron in the first decay pathway. And this brings up another subtle issue about beta decay. The amount of energy the electron runs away with is variable. It depends on the angle between the emitted electron and the emitted electron antineutrino. But the maximum energy of the electron is when the electron runs off with all the energy released in the reaction. So that's all we have to compute. And the strategy here is to look at the mass of what we started with, the cesium-137. That's 136.9071 atomic mass units, and I'm going to convert those to MeV per C squared right now. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 1.27528 times 10 to the fifth MeV per C squared. Now we're looking for a rather small effect, so I'm keeping a lot of precision. Next we do the barium-137, and I'm going to go ahead and add one more digit of precision to each of these calculations because it came in so close. So there was a 1 after the 8 for the cesium. And my barium mass turns out to be 1.275269 times 10 to the fifth MeV per C squared. Now the missing mass here, sometimes we use a delta M for that, is 1.17 MeV per C squared. And then the wonderful thing about these units is we can immediately get the energy equivalent of that missing mass. So I plug in to E equals MC squared, and the mass is 1.17 MeV per C squared. Multiply by C squared, and you've got your energy in MeV. So I get 1.17 MeV. So that's the total energy released as we go from cesium-137 to barium-137. In the second pathway, we emit an electron with an energy of 0.51 MeV, and it leaves some energy left over in the excited state of the nucleus, and then it decays down to its ground state and emits a photon, carrying away that extra energy. I know that my reaction produces 1.17 MeV of total energy. 0.51 of that was carried away by the beta particle. So how much must be carried away by the gamma? And I get that the energy of this photon is 0.66 MeV. And we're done. If you find the physics content on Zach's lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.